Comic-Con cosplay competition. It's good to see you all here. Thank you for coming out. My name is John Anthony. I am a YouTuber slash toast slash weird guy. I make things of the name Rad Science. You'll see a video later. But right now, I'm so excited for this because I've been walking backstage and the amount of costumes and the amount of talent that's gone into these costumes is incredible. So you guys are in for a real treat today. So first off, we have a couple of very special guest MCs here with me tonight. I would like you all to welcome to the stage one Miss Abby Darkstar. Now Abby is a New England bred, Southern raised, West Coast girl. Raised on a steady diet of science fiction, fantasy, and comics by her dad, and an infusion of theater from her mom. Abby finds creative and professional inspiration from cosplay, and her career in digital and social media marketing has allowed her to work with companies like Ubisoft, Crystal Dynamics, Kotobukiya. And Loot Crate, and her position as social media manager at Logitech G, the gaming brand for Logitech. Abby enjoys encouraging others to cosplay and enabling them to join all the fun.
I feel like I should be doing this while he's talking.
Can we give a round of applause for Miss Abby Darkstar? Thank you. And our next special guest MC, Mr. Keith Zen. Now, Keith credits Raiders of the Lost Ark for inspiring him to put together his first costume. From that moment in 2000, he's been dedicated to bringing to life his favorite characters, including one Mr. Negan. Now, from Batman to Tony Stark to Deathstroke and all in between, he strives to focus on the details that make these characters real. With a background as a martial artist, photographer, and charity work, costuming isn't just about the costumes. It's about the memories that are made while wearing them. And Keith credits cosplay or costuming for the old school for helping him meet and create lasting relationships with people all around the globe. Can we give a round of applause?
There are a lot of words going on. There's a lot of words. So I gotta ask this question. Are we all pissing our pants yet? It's gonna be PP Pants City up here very soon. So, you know, John, I don't know if you know the rules have changed.
Oh,
as far as how we're judging.
Oh, really?
We're using the eeny, meeny, miny, moe method.
Okay, that's right. That makes sense.
It'll go really quick. All I can say is welcome to the Planet Comic-Con Costume Contest. It's great to be back. And you can blink, you can breathe, you can clap, and you can cheer. Hell, you're all going to be doing that. Give it up for John.
Yeah. Thank you very much. We're going to introduce our judges right now. Abby, would you like to?
Oh, I'm so happy to introduce the judge. It's Kaylin Hoffman of Prop Customs. I think you guys remember him from that amazing group that he did a couple years ago. He's so
great.
Tall, so great. He's been making high quality costumes and props for 10 years, and his award winning work has been seen all around the world at conventions. And he's best known for his award winning Groot costume that I still have the flower for.
She really still has the flower,
really,
actually.
She's on my desk at work.
Thank you very much for joining us today. And next, let's welcome Tiffany and Tamara Dixon of Pros and Cons Cosplay. Pros and Cons Cosplay and Foam. And the character's name is Shell. Boom. Excellent.
We have Krista Reynolds, who's playing the character from Teen Titans, Raven. The item of piece that she's most proud of is her cape, and she used satin materials and black and purple thread.
Next up we have Jordan Stargazer with character Miss J, fandom from the Suicide Squad. Tattoos and shorts, both made in pattern, 100% by herself. Tattoos were added with women, shorts are patterned by hand, sewn, and seams finished. Use leather, cotton, foam, paint, all kinds of things. Excellent. Excellent job.
Awesome job.
Lucia would like to meet her bat afterwards.
It's a bat on bat crime. Next up, we have Audra Canita. She's playing Harley Quinn. She is from Hot in the City Comics. She's most proud of her shorts, and she uses a variety of fabrics from various places. Lots and lots of cotton.
All right, now we have Miss Brittany Rose playing one of my personal favorites, Katana from Mortal Kombat X. She's ready. She's got the fans. She can keep herself cool or murder people with them. It's talent. There we go. Strike the pose. Oh, she's dazzling. She's spinning them. Yes. Get it, girl. Excellent. One more. Oh my God. Oh, that's okay. Hey, wait. Hey, that's okay.
John, I think that counts as a KO on your part.
What?
You totally just like got KO.
I should have. I know. I failed. That's my fault. I messed it up.
All right, next up we have Leon Kilmer from God of War. It is Kratos.
Is Steve, and she is Kaylee from Firefly. Oh my gosh, you even got the parasol. Excellent. Now we have a duo, Chelsea Shia and Samuel Shia, playing Kate and Soul Survivor from Fallout 4. I still gotta make sure she's there. Yeah, I've got a water bottle. Yeah, that's good. Excellent job.
Good job, guys.
Strike the pose. Strike the pose. Nice.
Guys, I want half of whatever you find.
We have Erica coming to the stage as an original Dungeons & Dragons character named Alana Rickman. She is most proud of making the sleeves, creating the shield, and the materials she used, quote, pain in the ass fabric.
Excellent. You have to go to a special store for pain in the ass fabric.
And coming up next, we have Eric Scher and Gandalf. The service dog can play the Blue Falcon and Dinomont. Look at this. Oh, absolutely. I'm most proud of that helmet. Look. Oh, the dog's beautiful. Excellent. Excellent job.
Joey Tunis coming up with Battle Damage Spider-Man from Marvel. He is most proud of the mushy, mostly the web web pack because of how.
Oh. His suit may have been damaged, but his sense of humor still remains intact. Good job. Now we have Miss Kitty Brogan playing a Silent Hill nurse. Woo! She's probably gonna be scary. It's probably gonna be scary. Oh my goodness! She's fine. She's not a zombie. It's okay. Now her favorite piece is is her mask. She's made multiples trying to perfect it, and I think she did. What do you guys think? Do you think she did?
I'm not sure, but John's gonna jump off the stage again very soon.
No, no, I was told by the lawyers not to.
We have Derek Burdine as Harley Quinn, DC's Harley Quinn, and most proud of his hammer. It's made of PVC foam and a bird bat.
I don't know. I didn't know Harley had sexy. I never knew Harley had sexy sideburns.
Paw put it.
It's a pterodactyl back in that truck.
All right. Up next we have Gremlin. That's their name. Playing Jack Frost from Rise of the Guardians. Rise of the Guardians. Oh. Absolutely. Way cooler than Iceman, always.
Oh, chill my. Out.
Strike a pose, strike a pose, strike a pose. There, boom. Cold strike. And my turn. We have Miss Joy Brungart playing Rose Quartz from Steven Universe. Woo! Yes. All right. Now that is the novice class. So let's give a big round of applause for everyone in the novice class. Thank you. Okay. So moving on. Now we are with Miss Caitlin Bly.
And this is a journeyman class, by
journeyman
the way.
Journeyman class. This is the
just
first
so you guys know.
In the journeyman. Miss Caitlin Bly, Astrid and Stormfly, to have a champion coming out to you. She is fabric, cardboard, warbler, I don't even know what that is, hot glue, pool noodle, and just a sprinkling of hope. Just a sprinkling of hope. Beautiful. Look at that. That is amazing. Excellent work.
Let's welcome Jenna Proudmore, excuse me. Wow, my guilt's gonna kill me later. As the character Jenna Proudmore from World of Warcraft. She's most proud of her wig, her armor, which made a Warbla, EVA foam, fabrics, and a lot of imagination. Woo!
Excellent job.
You got some rep to grind.
Now we have Drew Donnell playing Senator Padme Amidala from Star Wars. Senator. Good to see you. You have horrible taste in men, by the way, just letting you know.
All right, next up in the journeyman class, we have Sarah Gagnon as Lady Loki from Marvel. Woo! The hand embroidery on her cloak and her staff are her most favorite pieces. She used fabric, foam, wood, and a stress ball, apparently, to create this magnificent work of art.
Excellent work, Lady Loki. Excellent. All right, coming up is a friend of mine. Her name is Allison Prue, playing Hellboy from Hellboy. With a lot of attitude to boot, Miss Allison Prue, thank you very much.
Let's welcome Joel Green as Princess Anna from Disney's Frozen. He's most proud of the amount and attention placed in the embroidery, and it's made of real wool and linen and velvet.
Strut your stuff. Strut your stuff. Work it, girl. Work it, girl. Do your thing.
Do you want to build a snowman? I'm just checking.
Don't build a small snowman, Negan. You always lose your head.
We shall call him Glenn.
Oh. Too soon?
It's okay. No, not for where I'm staying.
I'm married to you. God.
All right, coming up next, we have Kayla Jones playing Damian Wayne, the Robin from Batman. Most proud of red yellow tunic. She's knits, twilled, and craft foam. Excellent work. Excellent work.
I love it when Keith can't read the cards and he hands them to me because his contacts are too dry. See that? Let's welcome Jenna Boland as Noctis from Final Fantasy XV. She tried her best to get as accurate as she could to the character. By the end of Final Fantasy XV, she grew to love Noctis' character, so trying to get everything as accurate was a challenge, but worth it.
Look at that
Now we have Chase Brown playing a hunter from Bloodborne. Oh. Wow. Never tried anything like this. Use pleather, leather, snaps, and foam, wood, and metal. All of these combine to create the perfect hunter. Oh!
I need that guy to work for me.
Just stand right here.
We have Morgan Joelle coming up, excuse me, from a character from Black Butler, and I'm going to butcher this name because I've never seen this anime. Don't hate me, otakus. Lady Seal, Phantom Hive, Most Proud, Ciel. Sorry, my pink overskirt, because it took a lot of time, required problem solving with the elastic, and it turned out looking very pretty. I agree. And also the hat.
That's beautiful. Look at that. Excellent. And up next, we have Tracy Davidson playing Witch Skin Mercy from Overwatch. Whoa. Look at that. She's most proud of the staff and the wings and the shoes, obviously. She used PVC pipe, ABS plastic, EVA, and craft foam and fabric. Excellent work. Look at that.
Heroes never die.
Coming up next, we have Amanda Kizor, I believe, the Traveler from Journey, the PS3 game by that company. Anyway, come on up, Amanda,
where are you?
I did.
You're in that stupid bat.
Hey! The elements of the costume that she is the most proud of. Well, basically the whole thing. All pieces are handmade and meticulously sewn from fabric, foam, paint, Velcro, fleece, LED lights, and so on.
And coming up next we have Morgan Van Ross playing Vexalia from Critical Role. Critical Role.
All right, settle down. I will shut that S down.
She's most proud of the bow. It probably took the most time. It's probably the most eye-catching piece. I think she's the most eye-catching piece. Let's like, come on, absolutely. We'll talk later.
Well, about ready to catch your next eye is Mr. Sinister, played by Clint House, and he's most proud of the cape, which is made of fabric, foam, and wire.
Mr. Sinister. Excellent. The most subtle supervillain costume ever, Mr. Sinister. All right, now let's give a big round of applause. That was the journeyman, so let's give a round of applause for everyone. Good job. All right, now, let us begin the master contest. Are you ready for the masters? All right, here we go. Our first master is Mr. Bruce R. Holt, playing Morphoses from the World of Warcraft. Coming out, whoa! Oh my goodness. Whoops.
Silk.
The pool comes to you. Doctor Strange, excellent. Oh my goodness, the Ancient One. Good job. I love that movie. Up next we have Love from Rose playing Gage from Borderlands 2. Check that out. Show off that shotgun. Boom. You must proud of it. She's PVC, Warble, EVA foam, LEDs, fabric, hardware, so many things, and lots of attitude. Check it out.
We have coming up Samantha Ybarra, Marie D'Angelo as the Witch Doctor and Crusader from Diablo 3.
And Victor Tidwell playing La Muerte and Zibalba from the Book of Life. Oh my God. Wow. They used felt, flowers, feathers, LEDs, linear actuators, which sounds like something in the Back to the Future time machine, and a lot of other things. Look at this. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. Round of applause, both of them.
sets on fire. We have from Tolkien's Celeborn, from Casey Marie, excuse me, Renee. The piece she's happiest about is the robe draft pattern. She's, excuse me, I can't read the handwriting. And hand embroidered the robe and drafted the pattern and sewed it, the sleeves as well as added a detachable 8-foot long cloak.
Thank you. I feel so much magical now. Okay, coming up next, we have Angus Duff and Aubyn Duff playing Big Daddy Delta and Little Sister from Bioshock 2. What? Oh my gosh, yes. Oh my god. They made 95% of the costumes. 95% of that is all I made. They are most proud of the helmet. And they use steel sheet, aluminum, rivets, fabric, LED lighting, et al. Round of applause for them, with us. I still got a host. Maybe later. We got to come with that. Vroom, vroom, vroom. All out the sound effects. That works. Round, thank you very much, you two. Excellent job. Echo is really right there. I know it's.
Alright, coming up next, while Abby does a repair of her backpack, too much tomb raiding apparently, we have Austin, Batman the Jedi Knight,
awesome.
Batman plus Star Wars. He is Batman's, he is. Favorite pieces, his helmet, and it's all made from EVA foam, various fabrics, PVC pipe, bottle cap, Starbucks. What? Starbucks? Bill stuff. Alright.
I think Batman gets laid a little too much to be a Jedi, but he can deal with that. It's fine.
He had to go that route because I'm now the Batman.
That's right. That's true. All right. Sorry. PG. Oh, next up, we have genius, playboy, billionaire, philanthropist, warden of the North. We are Lord Tony Stark of Winterfell. Combining Game of Thrones and Iron Man and looking fantastic all the while. Bro.
We literally all know how this is gonna end. I'm just gonna take care of it now. I'm sorry.
Let's put it out there.
Let's welcome Shamus. Alex Carter coming in to play the character from Metroid. Most proud of her helmet. It's made of foam and urethane resin. Or his helmet. Sorry, Alex. Woo! You're so attractive.
Excellent. This one, I love Greek mythology. From Cheeky Cheetah Cosplay, we have the Greek goddess Athena, daughter of Zeus, sprung forth from his mind. That's mythological fact. She's most proud of every single part of it. She was Whirla, Lyra, resin, and EVA foam. And you look truly like a goddess. You got the owl and the shield. Because the owl is her symbol. I like the attention to detail. Love it. Excellent work. Right through there, Miss Athena.
Coming up is the character Taco. We have Mikaru Cosplay. The concept is from Podcast The Adventure Zone. And very, very super proud of the flaming, raging, poisoning sword of doom.
Oh, snap. You make the penguin jealous with that umbrella. That is amazing. Now, up next, we have Cal Power playing Hawk Girl from the DC Universe. That was amazing. That was, oh my goodness. Oh, my God. She used so many things. Feathers, fabric, make foam, plastic, PVC. Amazing job. Amazing job. Absolutely.
All right, coming up next is Jordan Dean as Moon Knight from Marvel Comics.
Too. Oh my God, you look awesome. I just want to say that. You don't have to look at me like that. Don't stare at me like that. I'm not doing it. I'm complimenting you. Alright? Round of applause, sir. Alright, coming up we have Kathy Miskill playing Princess Leia disguised as Boosh from Return of the Jedi. Absolutely. She's got the thermal detonator. Yato. That's the only line I remember that she says. She does a lot of bargaining with Jabba. Excellent work. Look at that. Don't drop that. Whatever you do, don't drop that. Oh, don't do it. At least stand away from me when you do that. Thank you. A round of applause. All right, let's give a round of applause for everyone in the masterclass. Okay. That was awesome. So let's give another round of applause for everyone, because that was so much fun. Excellent, thank you guys. So now while our judges will deliberate the winners of the novice during the masterclass, Abby and Keith will be serving as special judges for the group competition. So, here we go. So, we've got these. Okay, let's give another round of applause for our judges for doing it. They got a tough job. That is a tough job, because there's a lot of talent on display here. And so, we are going to begin.
All alone. This table's so big, and I am so sorry.
I'm still here, unfortunately.
Okay, Lucille's coming to dinner. Fantastic.
All right, here we go. You comfortable? Are you guys comfortable?
The seats are warm.
They are, well, they were warm, pre-warmed by butts. That's good. So now we have the DeGustos playing Captain Hook, Rufio, Peter Pan, Tinkerbell, Lost Boy, all from the movie Hook. Good job. hook has never been more adorable. Here we go. Now, coming up, we have Nerd Barrage playing Terror Tubbies. It's exactly what it sounds like. And here they are. She's apparently not. Are you afraid? Uh-oh. Fun fact, Abby hates Teletubbies. Oh my god. I'm gonna have nightmares about this for the next 2 weeks. It's awesome. Look at them. They are most proud of their onesies and headpieces. They're completely from scratch. They use fleece, nylon, LED lights, LED lights, I mean, etc., not LED, you know. Look at this. Oh my god. Teletubbies, terrifying people. Teletubbies, no one again. I don't know the Teletubbies theme song, so that's my time. Good job. Excellent work. Teletubbies, welcome on stage. Teletubbies, soulful rage. Teletubbies. All right.
I just want to say most of the kids may have grown up completely differently if those were the Teletubbies.
It'll be okay. Now we have Jerry Young, Chantel Young, Taylor Young, Edward, and Gabriel Young playing Misfit Mandos. Misfit Mandos. Walking on out on the stage right now, come from Misfit Mandos. Whoa! Look at that. Oh my goodness. They are most proud of the chess pieces. They used foam. And they did a great, great job. Look at that. Excellent. Round of applause. Okay, last but not least, here we go. We've got Badfish Cosplay playing Weiss Shu, Winsong Cosplay playing Yang Zhoulong, Legendary Rose Cosplay playing Ruby Rose, Average Asian Cosplay from Crow Bramwin, and Classius Cosplay played by for Adam Taurus. And they are from RWBY. Step on out. Group winner and craftsmanship group winner. Now, while we are waiting for the judges' choices, gotcha. Hey, you guys have to leave now. You guys just told the principal told me. You guys gotta go. You guys gotta go back stage. You have things to do backstage.
Bye-bye.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm serious. Don't get mad at me.
I'm talking Batman. He wraps turtlenecks, enjoys casual sex, and rubber nipples on his pecs.
Batman, he
Batman's always catching some sun and shooting guns and having lots of fun.
Batman
directs movie shoots, wears colorful suits, and buys fresh produce.
Batman
hangs out with Santa Claus, hitches rides from Jaws, and loves menage a trois.
Batman.
Yeah.
I'm talking Batman.
Who?
Batman.
What?
I'm talking Batman.
Got the best villains, and you know it's true. Villains like King Tut and Egghead too. If a villain fights Batman, Batman always wins. Even if those villains are super evil twins. His enemies are a tad insane, but it won't stop him from having brunch with Bane. If you try and battle Batman, you'll lose real fast, but he's got one weakness.
Catwoman's ass.
Catwoman's ass.
Catwoman's ass.
Making out with Wonder Woman, flying with Lois Lane, dominating Green Lantern, and loving with the parents, parent, too tired with Robin, asking about the Superman, slapping asses left and right, and squeezing titties cause he can. Because he's Batman, yeah, I'm talking Batman, oh.
I'm talking hot chick in a Batman t-shirt, thank you Google.
If we're talking about the greatest superhero of all time,
well, then we're talking about Captain America. But if we're talking about the second greatest superhero of all time, well then, my friends, we are most definitely talking Batman.
All right, thank you. That wasn't too weird, was it? Thanks, guys. Appreciate that. Thank you. That means a lot to me. It really does. I now would like to introduce a special group that came from the highest hilltops of the Shire to the darkest depths of Mordor. Does anyone recognize that? Led Zeppelin? Anyway, okay. They are here, and they are ready to entertain you. They are the Fellowship Cosplay Group. Let's give a big round of applause for them. Cut this way. Give it around here. They are somewhere on the premises. I feel their presence. Somewhere. Here we go. Ominous music. That's always a good sign. It's getting spooky. Spooked. I'm seriously spooked out right now. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness! Look! Oh no. Looks like it's an orc to me. Looks like an orc to me. Be careful, they eat people. It's a fact. Oh my goodness. They're everywhere. They're everywhere. They're surrounding us. Look around you. Hide your children.
Just sit next to him.
is the most relaxed I've been all day, so thank you. Oh no. What did I do? You don't like my nails? I'm a nail biter, I'm sorry. Oh no. Looking for. She looks very comfortable. Oh my goodness. There's all kinds of things going on. I can't see. I'm just really spooked out right now, guys. Sorry. Here we are. How many orcs are in the audience? How many orcs? Some sort of magical gift you'd like to bequeath upon me? Oh, look out! Oh, God! Orc battle! Orc battle! Look out! I'll take it from the orc. Thank you! Oh, my goodness! Oh, God! Look out! Oh. They brought me gifts. Excellent job. Okay, let's give a big round of applause for them scaring the hell out of us. Thank you. Let's call it some cosplay group. And now, I'd like to invite back to the stage, Keith and Abby, please.
Did you get the present I sent?
I did.
It was in the form of an orc.
Well, thank you. I appreciate any kind of present, actually. Now, welcome back on stage, Keith and Abby, and they're gonna regale us with a few tales, because they've been doing this for a long time, and they've been coming to Kansas City for years, and they're really good to the people, and they do really good work, so I'm gonna give the mic to them right now.
So we just wanted to take this opportunity, and since I have my voice this time, to
What?
Oh no. Please tell me now you're losing your voice.
You know that'd make you happy.
Oh God, it would. But we've been coming here, this is the fourth or fifth year?
This is year number four.
Year number four. We've been coming to Planet Comic Con, and we have seen you guys grow from a smaller convention to a much, much larger convention, to which I could not even see the other end of the convention hall. Has anybody actually made it to the other end? Please tell me, it exists. It does exist. I told you there's something else.
Are there snacks? That's what I want.
I don't think you need to stop stealing people's snacks, okay? I know you like naked, but we need to stop this.
Seriously.
That's not what you said about my sandwich last night. You took it all.
But in all seriousness, not only has the con grown, but actually we've watched many of you guys grown. Lucina right here.
Hi, Lucina. She was a newborn little baby. She was this big and she was so cute. And we've gotten to see everyone go from, I'm not wearing the costume, I could never do that, until entering this costume contest years and years upon years, and growing, making armor, making the amazing costumes that you guys never thought you could. And for us, that is inspiring. That shows us that it's a love, and we get to share this love with you guys, and we want to take the opportunity to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for sharing your love of costuming, cosplay, and geekery with us.
I've talked to a number of people this weekend where I've said that this convention is truly a homecoming. I know I mentioned this last year, but it's like a home away from home. So we have our local conventions that we go to, we get to see our friends, and you know, family and that kind of thing, and same kind of vibe. But here in Kansas City at this convention, it's the same exact feel. And I'd say this about only a couple other cons, but this is one con I would not want to miss. So hopefully we'll see you again.
We want to see you guys every single year. This, and please, no one tell my mother, okay? Promise? Scout's honor? Right? Scout's honor? Okay?
Oh, here it comes.
I was raised in the South. Y'all have the best barbecue I have ever had. Please don't tell my mother, she will whip me. I'll get an Abigail. I heard what you said at that convention. Lord, I'm not a child, you broke my heart.
It's true. They're both her mom and dad were over at the house, 2 weeks ago now? So.
You may grow up, but you never grow up. Anyways, we hope everybody has had a great, great convention. We hope that you continue to have a wonderful, wonderful Sunday. It's going to be epic. We're going to announce the winners in a bit. But please, do us a great favor. Make sure you let the convention know how much fun you have had so they can keep bringing back the amazing guests like Billy Piper, John Barrowman, Jim Beaver, everybody that you got to see today, so we can have another great year next year.
Absolutely. And last but not least, you guys got to give yourself a hand for making this convention one of the best in the nation. So.
We should know.
Thank you very much. Now, we have some more special guests coming out to entertain the crowd. Give a big round of applause for Beard and Bean.
How's everybody doing? We're getting ready. So we're what's called filler. So what we're gonna do is we got a couple little gifts to give out, but they're geeky gifts. Do we have any geeks in the audience tonight? At a Ren Faire, Comic-Con, go figure. All right, so I've got a little geek test to make sure that you guys are genuine geeks, all right? So I need you all to make a lot of noise if you love the cult classic movie, Star Wars. All right, how about if you...
Make a lot of noise if you can name all four Ninja Turtles.
How about the who here loves Batman? Who loves Twilight? Who was it? Doesn't count. Twilight doesn't count, because see, Bean and I, we grew up in the 80s. Back when we had real vampires. Who remembers the Lost Boys?
Who can remember Fright Night?
See, nowadays, our vampires, they go to high school, they have dating problems, they freaking sparkle. When we were growing up, we simply called those the Osmonds.
The Osmonds. You know, we grew up in a much different time.
Very, very different.
We grew up in a time when vampires used to count. One, two,
God, you are geeks, all right. So we just have a few minutes to fill up while we're up here. One of the things we're gonna be giving away today, hey, Frankie, are you backstage? Or could you guys bring some of those goodies?
Yeah, come on out. They got handfuls full of crap.
Here's what we got. One of the things we are giving away...
We noticed a lot of people don't always have time to come up with a cosplay before con. Who's all had that problem before? You never quite get your costume finished.
So what we have here is we have the official Beard and Bean cosplay shirt. As you see on here, it has, hello, I'm cosplaying as, insert your name here.
I heart, well, we usually choose a name for you. Sometimes it's Casual Thursday or Emo Peter Parker, things like that.
My favorite was Tony Stark's Proctologist. So we're gonna grab a couple of these. Who here, let's see, if you officially can wear a 2X, awesome. All right, let's see, I'm gonna to go as far back as I can. Ready? One, two, and put out an eye. All right, very well done.
All right, I've got one for personal size 4X.
Nothing now. Okay. All right. Now we got a 3X. 3X. Okay. Frankie, hit it.
Do you want to break things? Because this is how we break things.
All right.
I got a 2X. Oh, yeah.
She had a better arm than I did. Dang it. All right. So I got a different t-shirt here. Donated by Emerald City Steampunk Expo. It's a medium. Who wants a steampunk t-shirt? Bam! Oh, God! Damn it! Abby definitely outdid me there.
You threw that like you were wearing a skirt or something.
Don't take his side.
Okay, so one of the neat things you should always do is find yourself a corporate sponsor. We don't have any corporate sponsors. However, we do have friends over at a couple of TV stations, and they sent along some swag bags and help advertise a couple other conventions that we've got going on, so we're gonna throw some of those out.
So little mini backpacks. Now, who wants one? Let's see. Okay,
the rocks are free.
And I suck. Wait. I'm gonna do this right, hang on. Like a wimp. I want to be able to get it at the back row. Let's see. All right.
I double dare you, Keith. And if we get sued, it's all in your name.
All right. Negan, you want to help me out with this?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I'll stand here.
Oh, yeah.
All right, you're Swedish meatball. Obviously, he doesn't play for the Royals.
Do you want me to do it, honey? Me do it? You sure?
Oh, he's calling his shot.
Drum roll. This could end.
Swing, bada 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 swing, bada 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 swing, bada 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 swing.
America, what you should do is swing at him like he's a Nazi.
Oh no, he did! Oh, like you all of a sudden developed taste, shut up.
That'll be retconned in like a year, it's fine.
There we go.
Boom!
Awesome.
All right, what else we got?
What else do we have in
back there? Because I got, let's see. Oh, I've got a couple more t-shirts here.
Yeah, t-shirts thrown
out. I've got a giant octopus steampunk t-shirt. That is...
Fans of Octopi.
Octopi.
You'd think this was an anime convention.
God, this is a 4X. So all you
know what I'm talking about.
I can go right here. I can hit that guy. Oh, no.
I'm going to throw this swag bag. It's got another octopus in it. And then it's also got one of my favorite toys, the Wacky Wally octopus in it. So, this one's gonna go high and lob, so.
And the cameraman was never seen again.
It.
I gotta be careful jumping off stage in a skirt. All right, so I've got a, what was that, a 3X steampunk skull. Frankie, hit him. Man! Oh boy.
Now, I was gonna say, that's Cuddle Buddy Frankie right there. He helps produce a little show called Con Artists. We stream on Facebook, Twitch, and YouTube. Check us out, Con Artists, every Thursday night. Little Beard has a podcast that he does Tuesday nights, called Concast. So check out those if you want to get nerdy with us.
All right, we got one more. What do we got? A large.
Make it happen. Yeah, see, you threw it further than I did.
I got outthrown by both girls tonight. All right.
Hey, girls can throw just fine.
All right, so this is the last of it.
Over this other side, they have not seen the love.
I love you guys.
So here, I'll toss my pencil.
No. So this is an actual octopus, a wacky...
That's one of my favorite toys. It's a wacky Wally. You throw it at the wall and it slides down the wall like it crawls.
All right. And then there's
Did you never science as a kid?
I never science as a kid.
That explained a lot.
That's why I do this for a living. All right, here goes. Ready? Oh, dang it!
There's something about the wacky Wally that it doesn't get to the wall.
Was that our last one?
I think
we got one more.
Right on. Thank you, Alicia. We've got some more back there if we need to waste more time.
Do they need us to keep going? Because we can keep giving stuff away.
You want to check?
I don't know. I think we're supposed to, dance.
You guys
now.
Just want
free
stuff.
We're supposed to dance now,
Abby
says.
You're supposed to dance
says.
Now.
Dan, I can't
remember this skirt.
But you're wearing a skirt.
No, I'm a little teapot.
No, that looks very much like a kilt. No. Why are you calling it a skirt if it's really a kilt?
Well, because I'm on stage, and when you're on stage, you wear underwear. If you're wearing underwear, it's called a skirt.
Little technicalities.
Nobody wants full frontal piracy up here, okay?
Are you saying Britney Spears wears kilts?
I don't know if you know this or not, but that camera right at your skirt.
Oh, dang it. You guys are making me. I should not have come out here today.
That's going to be a different show.
Yeah.
Okay, so we got a couple more bags and stuff we can throw out, guys.
Do this side.
I don't even know what's on these bags. Who wants to throw this for me? I've been incredibly unlucky. So, you with the beard right here. Come on. Come throw it up for me. You're going to throw it out there for me. Ready? Chuck it as hard as you can. Make me look good. There you go. What's this all we got? Oh. Right here.
Birthday twins.
Get ready.
They have to fight over it.
Fight!
May luck ever be in your corner.
I'm just trying to get out of here.
I think that's all the goodies. You got one.
I think Alicia's got one more right there. She's folding it up.
All right, so whoever catches this one is officially the king of the geeks today. This is how this is going to work, which gives you complete bragging rights for the rest of the convention.
That's right. In fact, you know what? You may be able to find us later, and while supplies last, I have some official Beard and Bean geek cards. So, yeah, right? Because you're awesome.
So... if you guys want one of these cards, you come over to the Pez stage. Anybody go to the Pez stage today over in the Planet Entertainment Zone?
Planet Entertainment Zone stage. All right.
We had awesome groups like Clearly Guilty over there today.
That's
a lot of
right.
good demos.
We got some awesome makers. Keith and Abby were there earlier today. We've had Butthead Studios is coming over tomorrow to show us how to put hair on a predator.
Right.
The alien predator. Clay was with us. Was Ascarbon Technologies. Okay, so anyway, this geek card says, this card certifies blank, and we will give you your new geek name if you find us. Blank is a card-carrying geek. This geek was there when Frodo and Sam destroyed the ring, when Vader told Luke he was... We'll tell you about Kirby Dots, Bow Truckles, Hungarian Horntails, and Thaco. Cosplay is for everyone, love and hope are eternal, and most importantly, life is fulfilled with the things we're passionate about. So you might be able to find us and get your Beard and Bean official geek card.
There were at least three spoilers in there. All right, I'm going to throw as far as I can.
Which isn't very far.
Give a round of applause for Beard and Bean.
Thank you guys, thank you.
Give his mic back.
Hey.
No, don't give Keith his mic back.
Oh, I want to though.
Because you know what, I need his help.
So we're doing a Renaissance Festival in St. Louis, St. Louis Renaissance Festival, great show. And we're doing a show called the Scalawags Pirate Comedy Show. And in that show-
Which you can find at www.piratecomedy.net.
So in that show, we used to have a member named Rusty. Now, Westy, in this show, his job was on this story?
This is the starter?
Yeah, because okay. I'm going to use him.
Okay.
So, in this show, Rusty's job was to come out, and we're telling the story of King Arthur. And in this show, King Arthur's old college frat buddy, Sir D. Pantsalot, comes out, middle stage, and every time we say his name, Sir D. Pantsalot, we have special trick pants, we grab him by the knees, pull him down, and there he's wearing a pair of SpongeBob SquarePants boxers with a very specially placed nose. So now you might already see where some of this is going, but we're gonna get you, come on out here, you're gonna help me out. Okay.
I'll hold your weapon, sir.
So during one of the shows, we're getting ready to do this big crowd of people, and we've got a director from another event there to see our show, and we've got an act from the East Coast, and I'm like, I want to do a really special show. So during this show, I'm going to go out, and I'm going to find somebody in the audience to pull down Rusty's pants. And all the guys look at me and go, no, because that's a bad idea. So I go out, and I get somebody in the audience to do this, and you're going to be my Rusty here for this experiment. And it'll be okay. And I go out and I get somebody like you, sir. What's your name? You don't have to come up, but what's your name? Joey? Okay, so I go out, and during the show, I go, Joey, come on up. Now, Rusty gets up front, and he starts doing his dialogue, and I go, Joey, here's the deal. You have to grab these pants by the knees, because if you grab them by the hips and pull, it's a whole nother show.
We usually save that for the smoker.
He's like, no problem, I got this, okay? So what he does is Rusty stands there heroically for me. And we go, Sir D. Pantsalot. Now turn this way, the way you see it from the side view, okay? Because Joey comes up, grabs those pants by the hips.
When he was told not to grab it by the hips,
he pulls, bang, down like this, right? So now the audience goes silent. And you can tell the difference between the Ren Faire folk and the other folk, because the Ren Faire folk are smiling and laughing, and the other folk are in shock. But Rusty knows what to do. Now, if you're Rusty standing there, and what would you do? You would say, I'm gonna pull up my pants. Now go ahead and pull up your pants. Here's Joey. Nose to Rusty Starfish right on stage for everyone to see. Now that moment lasted, what, 15 minutes, right? They
just stand there in horror.
So it was a bad visual. So Rusty stands up because he's already a little nervous because everybody saw his full frontal nerdity. And it wasn't a pleasant day, it was a cold day. At this point, if you would have cut 2 inches off his unit, he would have had a scab on his butt, all right? So he pulls up, and Rusty and Joey, they do the show, and all the guys do the show. Everything goes out great. And somehow we save the show. But the next morning, they invite all the performers to special meeting. And at this meeting, they say, okay, now nobody mess up today like the scallywags did yesterday.
But wait, there's more.
Shanty Man and Pirate Lass, another group that was there, Shanty Man looks at me and goes, what's the deal? What happened? So we tell the whole story, and Rusty's red in the face, and everybody's laughing. The whole time, Shanty Man just stands there, doesn't say a word. So what's wrong? Did I tell the story wrong or something? I mean, Rusty's embarrassed. He goes, enough small talk. Let's move on to bigger things. And that was Rusty's last show.
He retired. We brought on Robin Banks.
I did that just because I wanted to be up close to his butt. That was nice. All right.
I got to piggyback on this story because it is highly relevant to this. But it's not my story. How many of you guys have watched Battlestar Galactica? The new one. I'm talking the new one.
There are children in this audience.
It's okay. If Edward James almost can tell the story in front of kids, so can I. All right, so much like this story that he just told, on set they have all the sound guys, right? They're miking up everybody, running the wires up through their uniforms, and you know, so this way they can get all the best sound possible. Well, one of the cast members that works on the deck was notoriously known for being commando, which is basically code for not wearing underwear with your uniform. Imagine if you will. So in order to get the wire run, you gotta kinda take part of the uniform off, so you take off half the jumpsuit, you got your racer tanks going on, and the sound guy comes and he starts doing the wiring, right? But unfortunately, the cast member at the time didn't realize that his suit slipped down a little further than he expected. It got a little drafty, and as Eddie James almost said, "You've heard the term cold cock, haven't you?" That story.
So, along the Battlestar Galactica theme...
You know children are in this audience, right?
Well, this is actually a cautionary tale that actually happened to me, not just somebody else's story, Keith. So, I'm not sure if some of you guys have seen my Starbuck, and I get really into character when I'm playing Kara, because Kara Thrace. She's fracking Starbuck. You know, you're not gonna tell Starbuck what to do, but she's just gonna tell you what to do, Nuggets, right? So we are at San Diego Comic-Con, and this is when Tequila and I broke up permanently. We will never get back together. We should have stayed apart in college, never, never, ever gotten back together. So I had had a little prop incident where some not so nice person decided to grab a hold of my props and made me a little upset, so keep me some medicine. We're going to a prop party, and it's in what I don't realize is a Navy bar in San Diego. So Abby's in Starbuck, a little happy on tequila. Except it's not happy bouncing, it's... Fracker. And I'm going through the bar, and all of a sudden, I hear, "Hey, Laura Croft!" And I'm dressed as Starbuck. "What did you just call me, Nugget?" I march over to this table that I didn't realize was filled with a bunch of Navy boys. Fresh out of basic. I turn the chair around. Sat down and went, "I'm Mother Frackin' Kara Thrace, but you guys can call me Starbuck, and all y'all Nuggets are doing a penalty shot." And I grab the waitress, do not grab people, that's rude, grab the waitress and yank her over and go, "These frackers are all doing penalty shots and they're paying for them." And I have a friend who's an army captain, served in Afghanistan, and she's amazing, and she's going, and I have no idea what she's doing. And the guys are like, "Okay." They took their penalty shot, and then I explained to them what we were doing because they have a bunch of costume people in their bar and they're going, "So we get them to do a penalty shot and end up having a wonderful time. But cautionary tale is, please do not imbibe alcohol and then go to a Navy bar."
Guess who's back? Back again. Guess who's back?
Oh, don't do it. No?
Do you see what's happening? Yeah,
you don't it.
Go ahead. All right.
I even haven't had tequila.
Can I have some?
Well, yeah. John, you back there?
Mr. Ann,
what's your... Are you fully clothed? Looks like we got a story for next time, all right?
He might be mic'd and still in the restroom.
I had a play where that happened. We were doing the Music Man. And the lead...
There he is.
Okay, never mind. No peace story.
Thank you, John.
Okay, here we go. For that moment of truth, if we can get the judges. All right. So. That's good sustain. I like that. Okay, here we go. Now it's time. Right now. Now is the time right now. To do this, so We're gonna announce our winners. Ready? So, for the Novice Showmanship Award goes to Leon Kilmer as Kratos from God of War. And Kratos is going to win a $50 US toy and costume gift card, courtesy of US Toy. And the trophy, round of applause for this man. Round of applause, take a bow. Come with me, sir. Come with me, good sir. Come on to stand. I think we match well, too. Look, I think we match. Like, do we match? I think we got. I like your color scheme. You should hang later. Do red and white things. There we go.
You bring me about it.
You can take a bow. Take a bow. One round of applause for this man. That's it. Stay here. No, you're not. You're staying. You're staying on stage, buddy. Next to me. All right. So, see this? You see this? I know. This is too hard to read. Okay. Craftsmanship goes to Katie Grogan as the Silent Hill nurse. Oh, she looks so good. She's winning a $50 US toy and costume gift card as well as a trophy. There she is, sauntering at about right up, but get your trophy, get your prize first, Miss Nurse. There we go. Can you walk over? Like, there we go, thank you, I like that. Stand next, there we go. Next to this brawny man right here. All right, now, the best original is going to Nicole Marsh as Steampunk Captain America, one of my personal favorites. Also getting a trophy and a $50 US toy and costume gift card. Miss Nicole Marsh. When Captain America throws his mighty shield or umbrella. There we go. Step by here. Excellent. Stand right here. Next to the lovely nurse. Okay. Now, the best in class. Here we go. It's Miss Brittany Gore as Katana, who wins a US toy costume gift card for $100 and a trophy. Spinning those fans. She's fanning herself off backstage. One second. Get it. She has fans. There we go. Boom. Excellent work. Excellent. Let's scoot forward a little bit. Let's scoot forward a little bit. Let's scoot forward a little bit right here. You can scoot. Silent, it's hard for you. There we go. All right. So that was the Novice. Now we got the Journeyman Awards. So for showmanship, it's Miss Caitlin Bly as Astrid and Storm Bly from How to Train Your Dragon. She gets $200 cash prize, $50 US toy, costume gift card, and a trophy. Coming out with the dragon. The dragon, it takes a while to corral the dragon. It's okay, there it is. All right. Congratulations. Right this way, get your dragon over here. Stand next to Miss Katana. Thank you very much. All right, now, the Craftsmanship Award is going to Clint House as Mr. Sinister. Woo! Mr. Sinister. There he is, arch nemesis of the X-Men. What a man. He has a thing for the Summers family. There we go. Stand right here, sir, Mr. Sinister. All right, now we're going for best original, and that's going to Morgan Van Ross as Vexalia, who gets a $200 cash prize, $50 US toy and costume gift card, and a trophy. Morgan Van Ross, come on down. Whoopsie-doo. Yes! She got the one with all the fans. Where's her fan base? Give it up. Woo! That's right. Stand next to Mr. Sinister, please. There we go. All right. And now, for the best in class, that's going to Chase Brown as the Hunter Bloodborne.
$400 cash prize, $100 US toy gift card, and a trophy made by Mr. Dennis Chase Brown. There we are. Look at that. Absolutely right this way. Stand next to your friend here. All right. Now, it's the group for craftsmanship. It's going to the Teletubbies. The Teletubbies. That's a $250 cash prize, $100 US toy costume gift card, and a lovely, lovely trophy. The Teletubbies. Walking around with the Teletubbies. There they are, the Teletubbies. Take a while to get to the stage, because it's hard to walk in those. There we go, Teletubbies. Round of applause for the Teletubbies. All right. Stand right there. Teletubbies looking good. Go, Teletubbies, go. All right. For the best in class, that's going to the Hook family. Absolutely. Look at Vestos. Rufio, Rufio, Rufio. Uh-oh, can we get, can we hear it? Absolutely, they get a $300 cash prize, $150 US toy and costume gift card, and a trophy. All right. Excellent job. All right, here we go. Now it's time for the Masters. For showmanship, it's going to Robin Duff as little sister and Angus Duff as big daddy for a cash prize trophy from Bioshock. It's hard to see. Oh, I hear him. I hear him. Boom, 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 boom. There we are. Round of applause. Just sort of stand where you can at this point. Let's get a crowd stage. All right, now. For craftsmanship, we have Bruce Holt as Morphosis, $400 cash prize and a trophy. You remember him, he scared everyone in the audience. And he's coming out as I speak into this microphone. Slowly, he is walking. There he is, boom. Whoa. Now, for craftsmanship. Excellent, excellent, sir. Stand right here among your brethren. All right. For craftsmanship, it's going to Angela Rigamini as Gage from Borderlands. That's a comes with a $400 cash prize and a trophy, as always. Woo! A round of applause. Excellent job. Stand right there, m'lady. All right, now, for best original, oh, this was mine too, favorite, here we go. Miss Anita Holmes as Athenis, the goddess of wisdom and war, daughter of Zeus, sprang forth from his brain. She's a patron saint of the hunt, also in Greek religion. Oh, that's right, thank you, sorry. Call me out. I'll admit when I'm wrong. Thank you. Uh-oh. She can't hold it. It's okay. We'll put it on the table for her, and we will not steal it. We promise. Let's go. All right, Athena, excellent job. Now, for the best in show, that goes to Marie D'Angelo as Crusader and Samantha Ybarra as Witch Doctor. They're getting $1,000 cash prize and a trophy. Their outfits were amazing. Stunning. And there they are. Let's give them a round of applause. Oh my God, look at them. All right, everyone line up here. Hey, everybody. Can we give them all a round of applause? And a round of applause for everyone who contributed. Absolutely. Great work, everyone. Excellent. We have the winners of the 2017 Planet Comic Con Cosplay Competition. Excellent. Now, I would really like to thank every one of you for coming out here tonight and supporting everything that we've done. This is awesome. It's been an awesome night. I want to thank Keith and Abby for being my lovely co-hosts and for not hitting me over the head.
And we want to thank you, John.
Thank you, John, for another year and not leaping off the stage.
I didn't leap this time. I made a promise. And I would like to thank U.S. Toy Costume Shop for the prizes, as well as Dennis Butt for the lovely trophies. And we want to thank everyone here who came to Comic-Con. So a round of applause for all yourselves and
great
everyone
job,
one last
everybody.
Time. Thank
great
you guys
job.
For coming out. You guys have been great.
Extra special thanks to the judges who are now hiding behind everyone.
Yeah, good job, judges.
Judges!
Woo! Thanks, everybody.
See you tomorrow.
Have a wonderful night.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome.